That additional workload comes on top of an existing vet shortage. In 2018, the major employers group, which represents big vet practices and corporate groups, found its members had vacancies for 11.5% of vets and 7.6% of vet nurses. Overall, it estimates that about a third of its members' workforce is non-UK EU graduates. What's more, it says that EU-trained vets are more likely than British colleagues to work full-time, meaning their overall contribution is even higher than the figures suggest. EU nationals are almost a quarter, 22% of those working as vet academics, teaching the British vets of tomorrow. The British Veterinary Association, BVA, is monitoring further shortages and has asked for government action to ensure EU vets can continue to be recruited. It points out that vets are important to the economy. Livestock and the horse industry alone generate £21 billion a year. Britain will hope to continue to attract vets from the EU and elsewhere, but the concerns in the profession and in the meat industry are real, and as those of us who own pets know already, insurance costs and vet bills for our animals can be crippling. If you own a dog, horse, cat, or other pets, you may also find Brexit brings a shortage of the qualified people who are trained to treat your much-loved animal. When more than 1,200 British vets were polled in 2018, 96% said the best option for Britain would be to remain in the EU. As Farmers Weekly put it, the veterinary profession is particularly challenged by Brexit, given that half of new vets registered by the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons each year are EU nationals, as are 95% of vets working in abattoirs. Fruit and veg. EU citizens are just 6% of the population, but make up about 8.5% of the total UK workforce across all industries.